You know me, my name is Shug, and I'm going on the third night of my pod system trials here. It's supposed to get down to minus 17.
Well, Shug, I think you're a little bit off your rocker.
Might freeze an eyeball. Worries me. Worries me a lot. I'm out here at Camp Shug in Sector 7 right in my backyard. It is right around 11 o'clock right now. And let's take a look at the temperature. Looking right there, minus 12 degrees. That's right, my friends, minus 12 degrees right now. The old trusty MSR going for melting some snow for water. It's priming right now. And then when it starts to burn down, then you turn it on, get your fuel going. What I'll do here is put just a little bit of water into the pot. Don't just put dry snow in there or you'll scald your pot. So there's a little water to get started. And I'll let that get going and I'll start scooping a little bit of snow in there. And dumping it into the boiling water. Just like that. Put the lid on there. Bada bing, bada boom. That's the winter way. Alright, that didn't take too long. We got us a right pretty boil there. This weather's cruel. Got a right nice big old moon up there. Minus 15 on that bottom temperature. Well, as I sit here, let me tell you what I'm wearing. And I'm quite warm. I'm wearing two black rock hats. I've got on a balaclava. I'm wearing this Go Light down jacket. I've got a down vest on under there. Trusty old orange polar fleece sports shirt. I've got a thin polar fleece shirt on under that. Got a thin polar fleece shirt on under that one, and then I've got a smart wool insulated shirt. I'm wearing my wrist warmers, polar fleece gloves. I've got my possum down gloves, and if I wear both of those, I'm usually really good. Got these big polar fleece mitts. They're like double thick, like 300 fleece. The only time I ever wear them is when I'm sitting around and I'm totally cold, but I bring them just in case. On my legs, I've got on some polypro long johns. I got those polar fleece tights, like they're cross country ski tights over that. I've got on my thermowrap pants, and then I got a pair of my good old Sierra Design rain pants with full zips. I'm wearing some down booties, and I've got some Neo Sober boots right here. My feet are totally warm. I'm wearing a pair of possum down socks that I sleep in. I've got a pair of big, thick, smart wool expedition socks, and over that I've got another big pair of wool socks come up to about here. My butt tends to get a little cold, so I've got my Jacks Are Better down sleeves kind of crammed down into my pants here. You can see them kind of hanging out. That is one of the best things winter camping. Those things come in so handy. I might end up putting them over my feet tonight. Might use them as pillows. Sometimes I might use them as a draft collar. We got minus 16 now. Getting close to midnight. Woo! Hey, buddy. I say it's time to crawl into that pod and go to the sweet good old land of Nod. The mass bandit is all zipped in here. Hope to have a good night's sleep here. Let's see. It is minus 17 right now. And I hope it gets colder. Laying in here, I got the pod, which is a 20 degree sleeping bag. It's a Western Mountaineering Alpine Light bag. I've got my war bonnet, Black Mamba top quilt in here. I have my winter Yeti inside of this. I've got my Go Light jacket kind of around my feet down here. I do have my little Thermarest sit pad, you know, just one of those little blow up ones you sit on. Down under my feet, and just kind of wearing my polar fleece shirts, Got my hood on, my face mask. I'm gonna put on my frost bib that's hanging off my ridge line right there. A couple of people asked the weight of this whole system, and with the hammock, probably about 4.5 pounds with the bags and everything. Comparable to a minus 20 sleeping bag, so I could probably go a little bit lighter if I was sleeping in a tent, but I just like my hammock too much. I just sleep more comfortable, my back feels good, but I'm just a hammock guy. Good night, everybody.
We got some coyotes howling. That's always nice.
All right, everybody. I done woke up here, and from what I can tell, it looks like it's minus 8 inside the tent here, but my thermometer kind of pooped out on the bottom temp. I slept warm. I got a lot of frost on my frost bib. Feet stayed warm. I totally slept like a log last night, so. All right, I put that temperature gauge in my pocket for a moment now, and you can see the lower temp, minus 14 degrees. Okay, I'm gonna put this camera away and get this coffee going. So here's the stove I'm trying this morning. That's called a Fancee Feast stove, made by a guy named Stoveman Dan on hammock forums. And it's a cat food can with a little pot stand and a little bit of wick. What I like about this one so far, no diddling around. Just pour your fuel on. And light. That was easy. Let's wait for some coffee. I did like the no fussing around aspect of that stove a lot. I mean, when it's this cold, right now my hands are out and they're starting to get cold real quick, so I'm gonna get my gloves back on. I'm impressed, man. I mean, it's only been about 5-7 minutes and we got a rolling boil with that stove. I gotta tell you, that little stove did a great job. Having the little built-in pot stand was nice. He's a happy man now. Yes, indeedy. You know, and that Fancee Feast stove is still burning down there. I could have put way less fuel in it. Got to learn how much to put in. I was just kind of in a rush this morning. Probably could have just used 3/4 of an ounce. Kind of good to know. It's hard to blow out, and I just don't really even have the wherewithal to try now. Did I just say wherewithal? I tell you what. This was the warmest that I've ever been winter camping. You know, the real test is going to be when I get out into the piney woods out there sometime and get myself another minus 26 degree trip. And then we'll see how things go. But one thing was underneath, again, on my butt, I was never cold whatsoever, or my back or anywhere, or my feet. I just had no cold spots on me whatsoever. And that's a mighty fine thing. Woohoo, buddy!
Me so happy.
Gonna show you real quick how this frost bib goes on. I got it hooked to my ridge line on a prussic so that I can hold it while I want. I have to slip that over my hood. I'm just back like this. So when I'm laying here, it kind of looks a little bit like this. Most of my frost and my breath is going right on there. I don't have any on my top quilt or the bag. And that makes me very happy, because frost is your enemy. Final thoughts. The pod is a great system. That was not that deep of a thought. These jacks are better down sleeves. One of my favorite uses for them is when I get up in the morning to have breakfast from the hammock, is to just slip them on. And whether I put on a down vest or not, just having these on my arms, because my arms are kind of out here like, danger, Will Robinson, danger, Will Robinson, danger. And then I was really happy with that Fancee Feast stove. There's stoves you can make yourself, and there's some you can buy from other guys. I fooled around with making them. I just prefer buying them right now. I'm just not that crafty, and
I never did good in sheet metal, and I'm a blader. Those are my final thoughts. I appreciate you watching. It's old Shug here, all secure in Sector 7 and snug as a bug and a hot chili pepper in a pod.
Shug here, everybody. And I got a little bit of a head cold, and what I do is I do a neti pot. That helps me out a good bit. I'm gonna take some water, about as hot as I can stand. You don't want boiling, because it's going up in your head. You understand that? And now I will add my little saline package that you can get at a pharmacy. Then I put the little lid on the neti pot, and I will give it a little shake to mix it up. Put it into my nostril. Let it come out my other nostril. And then I do it again. I like to suck it up into my head. Because all kind of nasty stuff comes out. But the gentle way is just to let it run through and wash your nasal cavity out. God, that is sexy. I always feel a little cheap afterwards. Remember, kids, I'm a trained professional. Please don't try this at home. Make sure your doctor has told you it's okay. Make sure your parents are standing by, or anybody to watch you do that, because you should never waste a neti pod moment. Neti pod! And don't try to blow your nose right after, because your head is really clogged up and you'll pop your ears real bad, and that's a serious thing. Ask me how I know. What? Huh? What?